What if I told you that you could lift something the weight of a grand piano, a baby elephant, or a pile of over 200 bricks with this? This lightweight lifting beam can weigh as little as 9 pounds while lifting a half a ton. There are models that lift up to 3 tons that weigh less than 25 pounds. In this video, we look at Caldwell's Dura-Lite Composite Lifting Beam. My name is Ben, and this is the Lifting and Rigging Channel. Today, we'll take an in-depth look at Caldwell's Dura-Lite Composite Lifting and Spreader Beams. Dan Mongan, Caldwell's Senior Sales Engineer, explains the pros and cons, real-world applications, and why you might want to choose composite over a metal beam. So, let's get into it.
It really is innovative. Nobody else in the industry has lifting equipment that is manufactured from composite. And in fact, Caldwell has a patent on this technology. The technical word for the materials we're using is FRP, or fiber reinforced polymer. So it's essentially a high strength fiberglass that's specially developed for what we're doing. There's a lot of significant advantages to using composite over a steel version. So the obvious one is they weigh about half of what a steel version would weigh. You're on a construction site, you can just place it in the back of a pickup truck. Where if you had a steel version, you'd have to get a forklift or you'd have to use a crane to move it. There's certainly advantages to freight. You know, these items can very easily go, you know, UPS or FedEx, to where, again, steel versions would have to go, you know, LTL freight. Aside from weight, other advantage are corrosion resistance. So if you think about the marine industry, right? What an ideal piece of equipment to use on a ship that may need a lifting beam or a spreader beam. It's just never gonna corrode. It's very chemical resistant. If we understand what chemicals it's gonna be around, it oftentimes is a better solution than a steel version. We found that it really works well in is the utility industry. So it's non-conductive. We have very specific electrical ratings in our manual. Let's say a utility truck, they're out in the field and they're working near high power lines. It's a huge advantage to them to have a lifting beam that's not conductive. From a manufacturing standpoint, there's some advantages too, right? So we have very specific methods in how these are manufactured, but they don't require a certified welder, right? So in these times, in the economy, there, you know, you can have difficulties in finding welders. Well, we can manufacture composite beams without needing that certification. Is it as strong as steel is kind of a hard way to define. I will tell you that the testing we've performed exceeds testing that we would do in steel versions. And I'll tell you this story, and I've shared this many times, and that is that when Doug Stitt said, hey, you know, we need to develop composite lifting equipment, we just were very skeptical. But as we involved some people in that industry to help us develop it, we did testing, we learned that it was just amazingly strong. That's quite a story about what Caldwell had done to develop this. It took us, you know, probably 2 years, and part of that 2 years was doing environmental testing. So we took samples to a laboratory and, you know, we froze them to 30 below zero. We took them to 150 degrees and did testing. Composite materials and the adhesive that we use actually become stronger the colder it gets. And then we did on the order of 120 destructive tests before we launched the product line. Because Caldwell knew that there would be some concern about going composite, we decided to develop them to meet BTH Category 3, which is over and above the typical steel versions. To prove that, we hired an outside contractor to do fatigue testing. So took a sample to them, they put it in their tester, and our goal was to go over 2 million cycles, and everything way exceeded that. In fact, in 2 tests, the rigging failed and the beam did not. Yeah, I mean, they called us and said, hey, it failed, you know, and you get that news, oh. And then it was a picture of a hammer lock that had failed. The one disadvantage I would tell you, and this is an interesting test that we did. We literally drove over a steel beam with a forklift, and then we drove over a composite beam with a forklift. Well, in that instance, certainly the steel beam would, you know, dealt with that way better than the composite. So in extremely abusive environments, I would want to use a steel beam. In addition, there's heat restrictions, and there certainly are heat restrictions in steel, but we could engineer a steel lifting solution to deal with, you know, thousands of degrees, to where a composite has a temperature limit of 150 degrees. A good example is Caldwell builds mill duty equipment to be in steel mills and hot situations. You know, in those cases, you know, I would not apply Dura-Lite to that. One of the more fun projects that we're involved in is we put a lifting system in a theme park in Florida in their aquarium to lift mammals. So went down there and was able to actually go into the aquarium and see some of the dolphins and things that we would be lifting, and helped them determine a really great solution and how to lift them. They don't make lifts all the time, so they want to disassemble this system. It's actually comprised of three beams put together. They would disassemble it and just store it away, you know, under a bench or whatever it might be. So it was lightweight, easy to work with. And again, this is a saltwater aquarium, so there's just no corrosion. It can be used in a combination too. There's instances where we'll make some of the structure out of steel and then other parts of the structure out of composite. You know, many, many years ago, there were wire rope slings and chain slings. And then somebody said, you know, hey, here's a synthetic sling, you know, nylon sling or polyester sling. And I think there was a lot of skepticism at that point. But today, that's predominant, right? So round slings, polyester, nylon, just a big part of the industry. So I think Dura-Lite is the same situation, right? So as it progresses in its life, I just think it's gonna be more and more part of this industry. It was one of the most exciting projects that I've been on here at Caldwell. And what it does is it really demonstrates how innovative this company is. That's for sure.
If you want more information or you're looking for some help planning a lift, then you can contact Caldwell or Mazzella's Lifting and Rigging Division. The links are in the description below. If you have any questions, drop them in the comments and Dan or I will find you an answer. If you found this video useful, informative, entertaining, or you just feel like being friendly, then hit that like button so we can get this information out to everyone who needs it. Subscribe and hit the bell so you never miss a video. My name is Ben, and I'll see you in the next one.